This is Jonathan Ferguson, the Keeper of Firearms and Artillery at the Royal Armouries Museum in the UK, which houses a collection of thousands of iconic weapons from throughout history. And this week he's taking another look at the weapons from the 2023 remake of Resident Evil 4, including the iconic Chicago Sweeper and of course its legendary Infinite Ammo Reload.
The Thompson, I remember this quite distinctly from the original version. Now, this one's much improved, I think, but we still got, and I remember that it was a reload animation, complete with a little spin and a tip of the hat. God damn.
Make sure to subscribe and check out our other video on the guns of the remake of Resident Evil 4, and let us know what other games or guns you'd like to see Jonathan break down in the comments section below. Right, let's take a look at more of the weapons from the remake of Resident Evil 4.
I thought this must be a new pistol in the remake of Resident Evil 4 because the Springfield XD, when the original RE4 came out, was not super new, but very new to the American market under that Springfield XD name. For those of you who don't know, designed and made by a Croatian company called HS Product. And we don't have an XD, but we do have an XDM. Different in a lot of details to the gun on screen anyway, so not massively helpful to show you, but we have managed to get an example of this very important modern series of handguns for the collection, for sort of reference and for posterity. That's what it's supposed to look like as the M model. It's a compact pistol, so it's smaller than what's shown on screen. Having cross-referenced with some imagery though, the RE4 remake version is looking pretty good. It's got all of the right design features, a couple of minor differences. I think the finger grooves on the front are probably taken from the Gen 3 Glock, for example, and a couple of cuts and other features are slightly different shapes, but it's so close for a game of this nature that's not milsim by any means. I think we can let them off for that. All right, another pistol. I think it's probably meant to be a SIG P226 X5 or maybe an X6. As with most of the Resident Evil guns, it's not kind of, well, it's high fidelity graphics wise, but it's not kind of slavishly correct to the gun, close enough. This one's got a really weird looking, well, sort of weird looking for a pistol anyway, birdcage flash hider type. Although I think it might have a breaching style crenellated front on it as well, an extended magazine and an interesting little medallion I didn't quite catch the significance of. Otherwise, it's a pistol, you know, what are you going to do? I do like the way this game treats the over-the-shoulder view as far as the weapons are concerned, because it sort of showcases them as they're being held. And you almost get a sort of zoom effect, and you can sort of admire them, which is nice. In third person games, the weapons are often pretty hard to see, especially if they're forever in sort of a low ready and then in the aim. As much as they're not trying to make these things incredibly faithful, they're good bits of video game art, and you can get a really good view of them as well. Always good to see the Winchester 1887 shotgun. You've seen this very one from our collection on this series before. It's relatively short-barreled, but it does still have the buttstock, and it's not as short as the version in the game, which has done a good job, I think. The one thing that stuck out for me that I've never seen before, and I suspect is entirely made up, is the way they've modified the lever with these big curved flanges that appear to be part of the lever, which you could put on there, I suppose, if you wanted to. And then when it's closed, they are covering a lot of the grip. So as you grip the gun, your hand is around those big curved flanges. Now, I think that would actually be problematic for operating the gun. They probably still work, but they're not adding anything. Now, the way you would want to modify this gun to do the John Wayne / Arnold Schwarzenegger flip cocking that we love so much and is in the game and looks awesome, the way you'd want to modify it is by enlarging the loop quite significantly so that when it spins around your knuckles, it doesn't snap your fingers. So I don't really know why they've gone for that, other than maybe just to look a bit different. I think it slightly ruins the look of the gun. You already lost a lot of the wood, so to cover up some more of the wood, not a huge fan of that design decision, but otherwise, it's a very cool gun. As you can see, if you did cut this thing down, and then you blanked off the end of the magazine tube, unless you moved this bracket here down the barrel, which is probably what you'd want to do, to be fair, you would end up with the magazine tube sort of floating in space. I mean, it's securely attached to the receiver, so it would probably work, but I would prefer to see the support at the front there. All right, Benelli M4. We've shown this one before, I believe. It's relatively new to the collection still. The distinctive buttstock is represented in the game. Don't think it factors into gameplay at all, but press button, turn, slide, a little bit unusual. It also got the Picatinny rail clamped to the top, or screwed to the top, and rather more pronounced sights, which are certainly standard now. Game version has much more traditional minimalist shotgun sights on it, so that might reflect the sort of 20 years ago era of the game, I'm not sure. But it's a pretty damn faithful representation. I mean, compared to a classic Doom 2 super shotgun with its insano spread from its short barrels, this is a relatively realistically tight shotgun pattern, but for a game. I mean, it's shown to be absolutely devastating, and relatively speaking, buckshot absolutely is out of a shotgun. Might be a little bit OTT, but then so are sort of zombies. To start off with this, here's a bit of tedious behind-the-scenes information for here at the Royal Armouries. So I'm Keeper, as you know, of Firearms and Artillery. My counterpart, Henry, hello Henry, looks after edged weapons and armour and Asian and African collections as well. Now, for the most part, bows are in his inside of the house and crossbows fall under me. So I'm supposed to know about this stuff. Now, this is an amalgam of, first of all, the long tail on the rear that Leon is levering down on to cock this thing is absolutely a design feature of modern crossbows, pistol crossbows, where rather than use some sort of a crankin or a windlass or even just if it's got cams on it, just pulling it back with your fingers, you break it almost like an air gun and it ratchets back the bow string. That's a design feature you'd recognize if you had a modern pistol crossbow, which this is, doesn't have a buttstock. The other thing that comes to mind, apart from our two rare OSS crossbows, one of which has incendiary bolts, which is a little bit adjacent to what we see here. But anyway, the other main one is our Chinese repeating crossbow, which is a box hopper that sits on top and a stack of bolts or quarrels, and they drop onto the sort of feed tray or the shooting tray, as it were. So we have a number of things in this collection that come to mind when I look at this thing, but it's completely fictional in itself. You could build it, you could absolutely build it, but its power level would be low. It doesn't have cams or clever systems to give you easy spanning, but high power, it would be really quite weak. Having said that, the way the bolts stick into the enemies, they don't go very far in, so maybe it's plausible. What, of course, isn't that plausible are the exploding bolts. I'm sure someone could design those as well, but they'd be really quite dangerous. Any kind of misfire and you've got an explosive in front of you. But I always enjoy seeing crossbows and bows in games to balance out, give you something a bit different than the boring old firearms. You know, who's interested in those? Right, this guy looks like, Ezio after a really bad night. He's got a crossbow type weapon on a bracer, albeit it's not on the underside concealed. I guess it's so overt, it's covert. Not really a crossbow either, because it seems to have two sort of flywheels, like the later Nerf guns. They operate by flinging the foam darts between two flywheels. Wheels that spin very quickly, and through friction, they fling the projectile forward. Obviously, that's very different to a crossbow, which is using stored spring tension and then releasing it and using a string to propel a projectile. And the magazine, there's clearly a magazine built into it it can't be gravity fed like the Chinese repeating crossbow of history. Well, it could be, I suppose. Could be gravity fed, but it's just as plausible that there's a spring inside it. And then hanging off, I think I can see in the concept art, I can see what looks to be a bicycle brake cable. So I'm not sure what that does. Okay, the Steyr TMP, tactical machine pistol. The one I've chosen today is standard, the sort of 90s, early 2000s variant, like we see in the footage. However, this is very cool. This is a specific Steyr TMP holster, and it's marked Steyr TMP, 1993. This is not a normal holster. Let me just demonstrate how this works. So this would be sitting under my coat, wraps around your shoulders like a normal shoulder holster. I'm not going to do that. What I am going to show you though is how this very, in a very, very cool fashion, breaks out of the holster and you're ready to punch it out and start shooting with it. Quite an unusual bit of kit that we have there. Gun itself is, I think, quite well represented. Leon's firing, well, before the shoulder stock appears, he's firing it down at the hip, which is absolutely legitimate. That's how it was done for decades. And it's a good job. So I might point at polymer furniture and say it doesn't look quite right on some guns, but I think it looks absolutely spot on a lot of them as well. So this is nicely done in the game. Absolutely recognizably a TMP, proper TMP, not the SPP. It has this built-in foregrip on it. Absolutely essential for controlling it from the hip, as we saw it used there. Stocks you can get for this. We've got one that's a side folder. The one that's attached in the game, I don't think is real, but I could be wrong. Usual trade-off, makes the whole gun longer, more bulky, but it does make it far more stable. And you can see that reflected in the gameplay footage as well. We see the hand-to-hand magazine changes and this big old barrel sleeve that's quite indicative of the TMP. It's maybe a little bit narrow, probably one of the few details that doesn't look quite right to me, and that's threaded for a suppressor.
They keep coming.
Springfield, 1903. 03A4 is the closest real variant to this. Iron sights removed. Receiver remachined effectively to take scope mounts. The initial sort of gun viewer shot that I'm seeing has a slightly horrific Picatinny mount. I'm not sure how that's supposed to be attached. Obviously, you can do that. We have a number 4 Enfield recovered from Iraq, desert colored, and it has a Picatinny rail badly welded onto the top of it. So it's certainly possible, not recommended. Please don't do it to your beautiful old Springfield. So it's something very wrong about the ACOG on the Springfield, that the height of the optic above the combless stock is especially weird. Of course it would work, but yeah, this is the real wartime version, or one of them anyway. The trigger guard, minor details here, but this is a piece of sheet metal that's formed into shape and welded onto the gun there. The one in the game is this slightly weird looking, comes to a weird point at the front, almost like a, I don't know, Beretta trigger guard or something on a pistol. That would serve no purpose on a rifle, and in fact, it would snag on stuff as you move around. So an odd little design tweak there. But overall, it's recognizably a Springfield 1903.
It's time for a taste of your own medicine.
An emplaced weapon, a turret weapon, sometimes disappointing, I find, in games in different ways. This one looks pretty good. Appears to be modelled after the German MG08 ground mount machine gun, albeit it's on some sort of mounts that I don't recognise. It was probably made up. So two things I noticed about this. One is the rate of fire is pretty high. The all Maxim guns chug along at about 500-ish rounds per minute, a bit slower than this, I would say. It's quite a good impression. I think the spade grips are maybe a bit massive on it. So rate of fire is maybe closer to an aircraft variant or something that would look a bit different. In case anyone's wondering, I'm sure you're not, but let's pretend that you are. There's a very thin round disc behind the cone flash hider on the front of the gun. That is actually to hide the flash that comes out of the muzzle device behind that disc. So as if you're being shot at by an MG08, the cone flash hider, you know, we intuitively understand how those work. They literally hide the brightest bit of the flash. And then the disc actually hides the flash that's taking place behind the cone because of the way the gun works. Recoil operation, it's got additional muzzle flash. And so that weird looking flange that almost looks like, I don't know, a ray gun, a feature of a ray gun or something, that's on the real guns. And it's not armor. It's far too thin to be armor. Very minor historical detail that they have reproduced in the game, probably without understanding what it's for. And why should they? But yeah, in case you want to. The Thompson, I remember this quite distinctly from the original version, and it was not the most faithful version of the Thompson submachine gun that's ever been put to bits and bytes, I suppose. Zeros and ones. Now, this one's much improved, I think. First of all, we've got open bolt operation, where the bolt starts at the rear. You pull the trigger, it flies forward and gets blown back. That's nice to see. It's nice to see the bolt operating at all, frankly. Proportions-wise, it all looks good. It looks good in use as well. The side view in detail, yeah, there's a lot of fudging going on. It's still a hybrid of, well, take your pick, really, but probably the 1928, 28A1, with the ability to take drum magazines. And in basically every other aspect, it's the M1, or the M1A1. You can't tell the difference unless you take it apart. Rate of fire is too low. I think it's probably faithful to the first game, but not really faithful to reality. Even the M1 is at about 900 rounds per minute. So still a significant rate of fire. Of course, we've got here little infinity symbol. So this one is operating on infinity bullets. But we still got, and I remember that it was a reload animation in the original game. I'm guessing it still is in this as well. Complete with a little spin and a tip of the hat, tip of the fedora, in fact. So it's pretty amusing. I guess you can scale the realism of the game somewhat by using silly outfits and optional upgrades and stuff that make the not only the gun, but the character behave differently.
God damn. That was almost a pancake.
All right, guys, you asked for it. You got it. More guns from the Resident Evil 4 remake. Please do check out what we do here at the Royal Armouries Museum. I have an article coming out in a journal that I also am on the editorial board for, RMAX, a journal of the Cody Firearms Museum. So feel free to check out that site as well. You should be able to find that, no problem at all. Regardless of all that, we will see you again next time.